A retail giant has a message for Cosmopolitan magazine. Walmart has removed the magazine from its checkout aisles. The National Center on Sexual Exploitation praises the move, saying Cosmo, quote, places women's value primarily on their ability to sexually satisfy a man. Cosmopolitan is still available in the magazine section, and here to discuss it is Haley Halverson, the Vice President of Advocacy and Outreach at the National Center on Sexual Exploitation, where you worked with Walmart to remove these magazines from the checkout counter. Walmart says it was a business decision to do this, and it is carrying them in the other sections of the aisle. Why are you singling out Cosmo?
Well, we've been addressing Cosmo really for years, primarily because its branding really targets young girls. It has this bubblegum pink cover and Disney stars on the covers. But when you open it up, the articles are extremely graphic and encourage its young readership to engage in everything from sexting to pornography to even more extreme things like group sex, public sex, and other risky behaviors. And so we're very excited that Cosmo won't be in the Walmart checkout aisles anymore, just so it's one less drop of hypersexualized media that's bombarding families.
Is it just about sexual topics, or is it about their liberal political message? Let's take a look. Here's the lead story on Cosmo's website right now, and it's by Cecile Richards, the longtime head of Planned Parenthood. Inside the brutal fight to include women in the Affordable Care Act.
Well, we are primarily focused on sexual exploitation issues, so we're addressing the sexual exploitation side of Cosmo. But what's interesting is Cosmo really likes to wrap itself in this faux feminist mystique, when in reality, the messages that Cosmo sends about women's sexuality are actually the same messages that Playboy sends, that women are there to please men.
Are you going to target other magazines?
We're asking other retailers like Target and Walgreens to follow in Walmart's lead. And we're also asking retailers to remove the Sports Illustrated swimsuit issues from checkout aisles.
Do you think that there's going to be a major backlash against this from consumers?
I actually think that consumers are going to really thank Walmart. We've already had several thousands of people writing into our organization saying that they're just so happy that they can buy their groceries and not have to see Cosmo anymore.
Right, but there are so many others. I mean, there's just a sea of magazines and the tabloids that scream the headlines about affairs and lots of different sexual acts, as you say. So isn't this just sort of a drop in the bucket and more of a statement?
Well, I think that it is significant because while, you know, National Enquirer or some other news article might occasionally have these articles, every single issue with Cosmo is filled with this. And again, it's often targeting young girls. So I do think that it is actually very significant. But it also is a statement that we can't have a society that's fighting against sexual abuse when we're also accepting sexual objectification of women.
You know, those airline miles where they say, okay, fill out this here for, you know, to get all these magazines. And I have checked a couple of those, you know, the Cosmo, Glamour, Let's See. And they come into my house where I have a teenage daughter and I throw them away right away because exactly of what you're saying, because of those messages for very young girls. Thank you so much. I know that you've got a global summit to end sexual exploitation here in Washington in June, and we'll have you back then to talk about that.
Wonderful.
Haley Halverson, Vice President of Advocacy and Outreach at the National Center on Sexual Exploitation.
Thank you.